It's seashore. Very severe snowstorm. In this weather, deer must be gathering in a hollow ground shape. Over there, I know the spot. It doesn't have horns. Huh? Small horns? Anyhow, can be a small stag, but it's not my target. Today, I need a big stag. Okay? Go ahead. Okay.
Horizontal black line, back spine line. If you see this line, it's deer. This is the deer sign, black horizontal line. Okay, go ahead, it's not my target. Oh, another deer coming. So many deer, but all female deer, unfortunately.
It's stag. No. Female deer. Hips. It is. Absolutely. They are female. Not my target. 120 yards around. Anyhow. Let's go ahead. This way. Onto the ridge.
It's a female deer. This kind of thing often happens in the winter mountain hunting. I missed stag just before, and on the way back to the ridge I found it. It showed just its back line, horizontal line. It was black, and I gave it a bullet, but unfortunately it was a female. But it gives me sweet meat, you know, less game smell. It must be tasty. Okay, I'll bring it home and I'll do it from now. Okay. Ontario Air Force. US Marines. No, US Navy. This is sharper, clearly. It's a very good skinning knife, US Navy, Mark 1 knife. Upper guard, a bit annoying. To the anus, cut up. You know, to the car, 1.5 miles. So, I must leave this muscle. Not very tasty. Reduce the weight is important. It's enough. And I'll remove the fat tissue from now. But for the moment, I put it there. And backstrap. No problem. Wow, bleeding. It's pretty nice. Mark 1 and Ontario. Ontario is not very nice for some reason. Not fast. Oh, Mark 1 is a very good backstrap remover and skinner. For sure. No. Why? I don't know. However, it doesn't slide on the bone. It has a deeper convex angle for sure, but not performs better. No better. In this case, this is a much better knife. It's a US Marine knife. Slender knife. And it's my preference. this is a navy nut. Wow! This edge slides in the bone very well. As you see, it's a serious hunting knife, in my opinion. This handle kind of thick, but on the plastic glove, but its leather washer has a good traction. I don't care this handle shortness personally. It's a short handle for sure, however, for me, it's okay. What? Milk. Not very sharp. This one is USN Mark 1 knife by Kaber. This one is Ontario Air Force Survival Knife. You know, it's a survival knife, but tongue is thinner, Kaber is thicker. The upper one, USMC short Kaber. This has the same tongue as this one. Very good. I don't think the AFSK has a good tongue. Hello, knife people. This AFSK was not great in hunting. As you see, it took multiple rusty spots. I believe these spots took place during washing in my kitchen, just in 10 seconds or maybe 30 seconds.
wet before wiping. After deer dressing, I wiped every edge with gauze and put the fat tissue, deer fat, thoroughly. And after coming home, it was shining. However, after washing, rusty. This micro scratches is wrong. Easy to take rust. And why this was not great? First, this beverang is pretty deep. This thick and this height. Please compare. This height. And thickness. I don't think you can notice the difference of the thickness. But actually, this one is much thicker. So, the edge angle is much deeper. And for some reason, I don't know, but it took the bone. It bit the bone. Not slided on the bone. Anyhow, I will resharpen on the water stone to make a very flat bevel on it and remove these scratches, and I will remove this upper guard. Then I'll try this knife again. It's a difficult knife. It's an easy knife, very comfortable. Why? I don't know. The most impressive knife was this one. USN Mark I knife, K-bar. It's a very good slicer. And this polished edge didn't take any rust at all. And this handle is actually short. In this holding, the pommel comes in the hand. However, not very annoying. As you see, this handle is short. Just good in this fist holding for my hand. Anyhow. How holds the edge? No chipping. Perfectly, it holds the edge. It's a great edge, great hunting knife. No chipping. I made it sure with this microscope. However, cutting edge is hairy. Not so sharp as this Mark I knife. Mainly because of this edge angle. But I'm not confident that it will take a shallower angled bevel. If it holds its edge or not, I'm suspicious. Anyhow, I must do it. Removing the upper guard, and we grind on the water stone. And this one, cutting edge is hairy, the most used portion. As you see, this edge holding was not very good after a deer dressing. Through the microscope, I can see a micro metal rosin. Micro chipping, kind of. I would say it is roaring or some. Anyhow, micro serrations like metal racking around here. Maybe people will say it's roaring or wearing, kind of. Anyhow, this edge angle is very sharp. So, this steel can take this kind of problem. 1095. It's not a great steel, I think. I have struggled with this knife on water stones for around 5 hours. This one, 220 grit green carbide soft stone. This concave, hollow curve. I made it with this single knife today, 3 hours. And on this 400 grit, 1 hour. And this 800 grit, 30 minutes. And now I'm doing on the 2000 grit stone, finishing. And it's now no convex, zero grind, flat bevel, so to say, scandi bevel. Sandpaper was good to speed up, however, it made a pretty deep convex bevel on it, and the edge angle was too deep to be sharp enough for deer dressing. So I decided, I changed my mind to make it a zero grain flat bevel. And now I'm finishing. Okay, I'll show you. This is the Scandi USA. Anyhow, Air Force survival knife. Please look at this. I think this belly line is very beautiful. I ground off the sharp sole jimping and upper guard. Very comfortable. And I put a micro convex pebble, as always. Much sharper than before. Next chance, I'd like to compare with this knife. So Seal Pup Elite. It was an easy knife to put a convex edge on it because less metal on the hollow bevel. As sharp as this knife. Great competitors each other. This lock I moved from my old knife. I forgot the name. Anyhow. This package is very compact and I love it. And this package in the sheath, glossy, you know, leather and the leather, plastic and plastic. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye-bye.